This research really opens up a new way to process inorganic materials into complex 3D shapes using origami techniques.
Hello, I'm Sophie Rovner from the American Chemical Society. Welcome to this media briefing from ACS Spring 2023. The ancient art of origami is well known for transforming sheets of paper and other foldable materials into complex 3D shapes. But now, chemical engineers have extended the centuries-old practice to produce intricate shapes made of glass or other hard materials. Their thoroughly modern method, which can be combined with 3D printing, could have applications ranging from sculpture to catalysts and beyond. To tell us more, we're joined today by Tao Xie from Zhejiang University. He will describe the work of his graduate student, Yang Shi. Thank you for speaking with us.
Thank you, Sophie and ACS, for giving me this opportunity to share some of our recent work with the audience today.
Tao, where did you get the idea to do this project?
Well, over the last several years, we've been working on the use of origami as a simple way to make complex shape-shifting polymers. Origami requires the object to be foldable. Glass isn't, yet polymers are typically are. One day, one thought came to our mind that is, wouldn't be really nice if we can extend this technique to make origami inorganic shapes, which are really notoriously difficult to process into complex shapes because of their brittleness. There are really not many ways you can process inorganic materials. So we want to try that.
And how did Yang investigate this?
The first thing she did was to make a polymer composite that contains silicon nanoparticles. After she got that composite, she cut the composite and folded into origami shapes. Afterwards, she took the parts and subjected to a high temperature thermal treatment process, which allows you to remove the polymer binder and sintering the part into transparent glass.
And what did she find out?
Turns out that the formulation of the polymer composite is really important here. In order to sinter the glass, you want the polymer composite to have as much inorganic particle as possible. But if you have too much of them in there, the polymer composite becomes too brittle and it's not foldable anymore, which doesn't allow you to do origami folding. In the end, after her investigation, she found the right balance between the two and obtained polymer composite contains sufficient amount of silicon nanoparticle, yet with mechanical properties quite similar to regular paper, which allows her to do origami folding.
And what sort of shapes did she make?
Well, in principle, anything you can make with paper origami, you can do it with glass using our technique. More specifically, the type of shape that she was able to make include crane, feather, waves, flowers, all in highly complex 3D shapes.
What applications might this have?
Art making is the first one that came to our mind because the technique really allows you to make transparent glass with unique shapes. Obviously, we're scientists. So in the scientific field, we feel that catalyst support might be the next one that can pop up. But we have yet to talk to people in that field to know what their needs are. The other thing that might be possible is probably with microfluidics, where you need to have complex geometries in some cases, and also have the transparency allows you to monitor the process within the microfluidics. You know, beyond that, it is my hope that as more and more people with different background learn the techniques from this video, they may come up with good suggestions, ideas that we can try. in the future.
I understand Yang combined 3D printing with the origami technique. Can you tell me about that work?
Well, this is still an ongoing effort. 3D printing and origami folding are two different ways of making 3D shapes. We thought that if we can make the polymer composite 3D printable, we can then start with a highly complex 3D shapes as a starting point for origami folding instead of a planar thin film.
And what are the advantages of combining these two methods?
Combining the two methods would give us the freedom beyond either one of them. 3D printing is very versatile in making arbitrary 3D shapes, but its typical layer-by-layer nature limits its processing speed. Origami folding, in contrast, is really fast, but cannot access arbitrary shapes. We thought that combining them would allow us to take advantage of their respective attractive attributes while overcoming their limitations. This is at least applicable for certain geometric shapes.
Who might use these types of techniques?
I think anyone who might be interested in making inorganic construct with complex shapes would fall into that category. This would actually include artists, scientists like us, and even commercial product producers.
Thank you, Tao, for sharing this research with us.
Thank you, Sophie, once again, for the great opportunity. And really, my graduate student, Yang, she did the work. I would also like to thank the audience, today's audience, for listening. And really, with the hope that some of them who listen to this video may come up with good ideas and suggestions that we can try in the future.
Be sure to check out our other media briefings for ACS Spring 2023, which will be posted throughout the meeting at www.acs.org/ACS Spring 2023 briefings.